Almost everybody needs financing options when exploring a franchise investment. In this video, I'm going to teach you about the most common ways that people fund franchise investments and the timing in which to align that funding with your franchise due diligence process. When is the right time to start thinking about how you might fund your franchise investment? The Daly Coach would say, as soon as possible. Before we get to all that, if you're watching this video with the intent of trying to become a business owner in the next few months, know that I want to be your Daly Coach. If you will reach out to me on the link below, someone from my team will reach out to you within 24 to 48 hours so that we can set up our first call so I can get to know you and learn more about why you want to own a business and help you make that connection to the right franchise investment for you. So let's talk about funding, a black hole in the process that is franchising if candidates try to take it on themselves. I just want to remind you that as the Daly Coach, as the franchise consultant, I am not the financing expert. Now, I certainly know enough to be dangerous, and I am going to share a little bit of what I know with you today. But as the guide in your due diligence process, I would lead you to the people who are the experts. And really, that is the difference between there actually being a process that will lead you to funding your business and candidates going out and trying to do it on their own and oftentimes ending up in what seems like a black hole that they can never recover from. So there are many different ways that people can fund a franchise investment. That includes cash, home equity line of credit, stocks and bonds, a 401k rollover, or an SBA or traditional loan. So a little note about that 401k rollover, because this is a plan that most people are not really too familiar with until they get into exploring a franchise opportunity. So the ROBS plan, as it's formally called, which is the rollover for business startup, allows you to use your 401k without creating a taxable event. For the purposes of this video, that's all I'm going to say about the ROBS plan. If you're interested in learning more about the particulars of that, I would encourage you to reach out to me and I will put you in contact with some amazing people who all they do is help fund franchise investments. And they are the experts who can teach you exactly how that 401k plan works. But for the purposes of this video, I just want to let you know that your 401k is a potential way that you could fund your franchise investment, even if you're going for a bank loan, because many times people think that using somebody else's money is better. I guess that depends on how quickly you want to cash flow. But if you're using somebody else's money, the bank typically requires the first 20 or 30% cash injection. So let's say that you're investing in a business that all in is around $300,000. You might need to come to the table with the first $100,000. Most people don't have $100,000 sitting around in their checking account. And so that $100,000 could come from that 401k rollover plan. So you could use the 401k rollover to fund that initial part, and then the bank could come in with the other $200,000 to help you start your business. So these are some of the most common ways that franchise businesses are funded, or some combination thereof. But what I really want to talk to you today about is the timing of when do you start thinking about how you may fund your franchise investment. This year in 2021, the banks, like a lot of other industries, have been really behind, maybe even short on staff. I don't really know what is causing all the big delays in financing. I just know that what used to take a couple of weeks is now taking a month or more. And so the sooner that candidates engage one of these financial resources to really start understanding how banks loan money and what you need to qualify and how much cash you're going to need, and start thinking about that while you're doing your due diligence, then the easier the process will be at the end when you've completed your due diligence, you've gone to discovery day, you've been awarded the opportunity to move forward, training is looming ahead, you want to sign that franchise agreement and get started. but you can't do anything without your funds. So the timing of starting this conversation about lending is very, very critical. Now, I do sometimes feel a little hesitation from my candidates when I bring up the idea of financing in week two of this 1 to 2 month due diligence process. And I think it's because when we start talking about money, it really makes it real. And many times, look, this is an exploratory process. You can't know you're going to invest in a franchise until you've asked enough questions and enough of the answers have satisfied you, right? My process is highly exploratory, and I encourage all of my candidates to take all the pressure off of trying to say yes. Let the process unfold. Let the answers come. Saying yes will be a logical conclusion to having asked enough questions where then the answers satisfied you so that you feel competent that you can say yes. So it's a little counterintuitive to start talking about, well, how would I fund my business when I don't even know if I'm going to invest in a business? But it's also not a good idea to get all the way to the end of the process and say yes to your business and then have a whole nother month or two of a funding process. So it's better to start talking about it sooner rather than later. You don't have to take any action in terms of moving any money. That's not what I'm suggesting. What I'm suggesting is that you get familiar with how the banks loan money, what the different options are for you per the various businesses that you're looking at, so that you feel like you have options. That's the main thing. So working with an experienced franchise consultant is really important because the consultant can help introduce you to the right financial resources who can create funding options for you. Also, sometimes by knowing what you can afford because of loans, it could make a potential opportunity more exciting to you. On the flip side of that, sometimes when you hear what the loan entails, it might make an opportunity that you really thought you were interested in seem a little bit less interesting. So if you're looking at multiple concepts and trying to figure out how to get this down to one or two that feel like the best options, layering in how you would afford different investments can become useful criteria that you could use to help sift out options and get more clarity on what would be the right investment for you. I know that when you start talking about money, the whole thing becomes very real. But that's why in my process, guys, one of the very first conversations I have with people is about money. Years ago, I realized that the elephant in the room is money. The number one reason that people will start looking at franchises and then never invest is because of money. So as an experienced franchise consultant, I talk about money early and I talk about it often. I will explain to you what your money buys. I will explain to you what every franchise business costs and why. And then we'll relate that to your net worth and what you're trying to accomplish through the business. That's going to be criteria that I use to even match opportunity to you. So there's two things here, really. Number one is to work with an experienced franchise consultant who knows the process, who knows the steps, who knows the importance of aligning your due diligence with franchisors with your funding due diligence as well, so that the two will culminate at the same time. The ideal process would be where you end up at your discovery day, which is your closing tool. This is the last thing you're gonna do before you're awarded the opportunity to move forward, and then you have the option to say yes or no. But so you're gonna use this discovery day as your closing tool, but to go into that discovery day with a basic idea of if you decide to move forward, how you're going to fund your business, to know that you have within 7 to 14 days, you have the ability to get the cash on your hands to pay those franchise fees. You don't have to have a concrete plan for exactly how you're going to fund the business. The only money that you need right up front after discovery day will be the franchise fee. But I don't care who you are, nobody's going to give a non-refundable franchise fee unless you know that you have options or that you're pre-qualified for a loan. And that's what my financial friends will do for you. They will give you those options. They will help you get a pre-qualification. Things that if you were to go out on your own could take weeks, if not months, because they have the relationship with the banks, because they know exactly how you need to look on paper in order to get you approved for that business. They can expedite that process and get you that pre-approval. So that day that you end up at Discovery Day, that you're awarded the opportunity to move forward, that you can say yes, and you can be executing on that franchise agreement within 1 to 2 weeks. If you've made it this far in the video, then you're about to hear the most important thing that I'm going to say in this entire video. And that is that the moment you arrive at a yes, you need to be able to execute. When you go through your due diligence process, you're going to go up and down and up and down. Your emotions could be all over the place. When you're finally at that place where you have all the information that you can have, and now is the time to say yes, you have to be able to confirm that yes by signing your franchise agreement and paying your franchise fees. So it's no good if you then have to wait another month to be funded, because during that time, your emotions are going to continue to go up and down and up and down. It's a roller coaster ride that is so unnecessary. As your daily coach, I want to help you take the shortest emotional roller coaster ride that I can. And that is by aligning your funding options with your due diligence process so that you can confidently move forward when you decide that now is the time to change your life. If you are watching this video in career transition, or you are an investor who is looking for options to diversify your real estate portfolio, and you love the idea of exploring franchise opportunities, I want to be your daily coach. If you reach out to me at the link below, somebody from my team will reach out to you within 24 to 48 hours to get us scheduled for an introductory call. I can't wait to meet you. Please don't hesitate. If you've enjoyed this video and you want to see more, don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell.